different dependencies may be needed at different times in the build process. Logically related dependencies are grouped into configurations. So far, we've been adding dependencies to the compile configuration, but the Java plugin creates other configurations as well, such as runtime, test compile, and test runtime. The Java plugin ensures that the specified dependencies are on the class path when the corresponding tasks are run. Dependencies can be added to any of these configurations by simply using the name of the configuration followed by the dependency notation. Here we have added a dependency to the test compile configuration. This dependency will only be available from our test code. Configurations can extend other configurations. For example, test compile extends from the compile configuration, which means that all of the dependencies in the compile configuration are automatically included in test compile. We can verify this by generating a dependency report. Here we see that the compile configuration contains a dependency on commons logging, but the test compile configuration contains both the dependency on commons logging and on JUnit, and on one of its transitive dependencies. If you have a more advanced build, with dependencies that don't fit into a configuration defined by the Java plugin, you can create a custom configuration. Just add the name of your configuration to the configuration script block. We can then assign dependencies to that custom configuration. We can now run a dependency report to see the new dependencies added to the project. And if we scroll up, we find our custom configuration along with the dependency we declared. Under the hood, configurations are really just fancy file collections and can be used anywhere a file collection can be used, such as in a copy task. This is useful if we want to download some dependencies from a remote repository and bundle them in our project somehow.